you believe there's a moral equivalency in terms of what Hamas does vis-a-vis Israel in comparison with what Israel does vis-a-vis Hamas?
Well, the thing that concerns me about Palestinians in general relating to Israel is that there is no evidence at all that Israel is willing to have peace with the Palestinians if it means relinquishing the Palestinian land that they have confiscated and colonized.
Well, clearly they're willing to relinquish some of it, aren't they?
No, I haven't seen that yet. Let me tell you why.
Okay.
I don't know what everybody thinks, but the overwhelming portion of Israeli citizens are willing and always have been willing the last 30 years to exchange Palestinian land for peace. But the United States has a proposal called a roadmap, as you know. And one of the key elements is freezing of the settlements and not building any more settlements. And when they had the conference in Annapolis last November, the Israelis reconfirmed their commitment to the roadmap. Since then, thousands of new settlements have been approved and announced by the Israeli government, all on Palestinian land. And they have actually increased the number of roadblocks from 550 to 587. The United Nations and others monitor very carefully.
But is that, in your judgment, equivalent to whatever terrorist activities and whatever shelling that Hamas is doing onto Israel?
I have condemned the shelling of a little town of Sderot, where I visited, and Ashkelon, which I also visited, as an act of unforgivable terrorism. Because the people who suffered, they've been shelling for 7 years. 13 people have been killed. And the people of Sderot are living in terror. It's a town of about 20,000 people. We spent a couple of hours, two or three hours with the mayor. And you ride through this town, and there's nobody on the street, nobody on the playgrounds.
Right.
They're afraid of these rockets. Well, if you look at the statistics from last year, for instance, 2007, every time one Israeli was killed, 40 Palestinians were killed by attacks by Israel against Gaza. And if you just look at children, every time an Israeli child is killed, 8 Palestinian children are killed. So you can't just say that all of the blame lies on one or the other. So what I try to do...
But more than one than the other?
I'm sorry?
More one or the other?
I don't even say that. You know, I think anytime any powerhouse takes military action when it's a high danger or almost an inevitability that women and children are going to be killed, I think that can be considered an act of terrorism.
So yeah. Israel is engaging in acts of terrorism?
I think both of them are equally guilty, yes.
Okay, that's a moral equivalency.
I think
so. Tell me what you want to see America do. If you could write a memo to the next president of the United States, tell him what you, Jimmy Carter, would like to see him or her do.
I think the next president could change the image of this country around the world in 10 minutes. By making an inaugural speech that would start off and say, as long as I'm president, we will never torture another prisoner. As long as I'm president, we will never attack or invade another country unless our own security is directly threatened. As long as I'm president, we will raise high the banner of human rights and be a champion of human rights around the world. As long as I'm president, we will be in the leadership role of protecting the environment from the potential ravages of global warming. When I'm president, the first month I'm in office, I will start an all-out campaign using all the facilities and influence of my office to bring peace to Israel, and so forth.
Join us online at charlierose.com.